Welcome, Anders and YouTubers alike. Welcome to This Side of the Dark, where I talk about some of the current and future features of Elite Dangerous and speculate upon them. I'm joined in this episode with a special guest, Commander Kev Banufong. Hello, Commander.
Hey. Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
Oh, pretty good.
Cool.
So, in... Oh, Dr. Death song. Anyways, so this episode, a discovery has been made by Commander Zorback, and literally pretty much yesterday, and as soon as I scroll down, and you can see a new alien moon site has been discovered.
Alien moon site?
Yep. See a few commanders already down there on the ruins, checking things out. What's the other one? I see two asts and something else. I think it's a keelback. Not a keelback. We'll find out soon. Let's go find out. So, for those of you viewing, as you can see, this is IC-2391, Sector GW-VB2-4. Planet B1. And you can see the coordinates of -29.15 and -30.52. So this is a good find, considering that the engineer Lam Ta has put out that little quest, the little mission to collect the scan data from the obelisks using combinations of the artifacts that are scattered around the ruins. This is pretty cool. I've gotten like 17. I've gotten 17 data for it already. So this new site should be able to give a lot more scan data for it. Have you been to the first site, Commander Kev?
No, I haven't. But I've heard a lot about it.
Okay. Sweet. So, some of the things I talked about this on my last episode, which I just posted just recently. Well, I gotta get me an artifact list. Hopefully, in the same places. Is I speculated on what could have wiped them out. I'll do a quick speculation recap that considering that there's two factions and they heavily used AIs and implants, though the two sides of their civilization, one side was the division of those who could accept the implants and live with them, the other side was not adaptable, two-tier civilization was created because of that. So one speculation is they could have gone to war. Another speculation is they could have encountered the Thargoids early on in the space exploration and gotten a war with them. And considering that the Thargoids can, by our encounters with them, shut down our computers, those with those implants probably get those. Their implants all shorted out, and then they, probably bit the dust or something like that. So, I'm guessing their official policy would then to be to shoot first, ask questions later, because they're considered dangerous. So that's probably what could have started a war with the Thargoids between the two races. What do you think about this, Commander Kev?
Seems pretty logical. I mean, if one side's got implants and the other one's like not accepting it and they don't want to accept it, and if they're trying to like be divided, then I think a war between them could be really plausible. But who knows? And then with the Thargoids, I mean, they've interdicted us and managed to take our systems down, so.
Yeah, with those brand new plants, that'd be like a really bad thing. A really bad migraine. Anyways, as those who are viewing have noticed that the ruins seem to be exactly the same as the other site. So, which is not surprising. I mean, the site was primarily used for to help bolster their speed-like communications and how they communicate. So it's not too much of a surprise that they'll all be similar in design.
So like communication relays?
Yeah, pretty much. Same kind of thing, so... I don't know. I'm trying to find some bloody... artifacts, I just can't find them. Maybe they're spawning in different places, I don't know. Anyways, it's all pretty good. It seems like this site is operating fine because I believe there's a glitch with the other one where it's giving off too much data. But it seems like so far this one seems to be communicating just fine. If I can find an artifact, that'd be great. So what do you think, besides the speculate, do you think, even if they had a war with the Thargoids and stuff, do you think that they could still be around, like the home planet could still be rather untouched and just the technology, you know, pretty much ruined, or those that used the implants probably are dead and those who did not are still alive and maybe just haven't been able to get back into space again. What do you think?
That kind of seems like a cool thing to have in the game if that happens. Like, if they're like a home planet is still stable, but they can't get into space yet because all their technology's gone and been destroyed in the war. Then who knows? Maybe in 2.3, maybe we might know something more about it.
Yeah, maybe. But I think if that's the case, we probably won't know for sure until we can actually land on planets with atmospheres, like Earth-like worlds.
Yeah.
Depending on whether or not they actually breathe oxygen or not, like apparently Thargoids are ammonia breathers, so they find them on ammonia planets. These guys might breathe something else, so who knows what they breathe. Yeah. We don't know until we know more about them.
Yeah, but do we know if they're humanoid or are they robotic?
Yes, they're humanoid, and they just got brain implants, so like what they do with Halo and the Master Chief, with Spartans, kind of same kind of deal.
Like the AI, like Cortana.
Yeah, I don't know how deep how much of a AIs they did. I don't know if they did the one with the full holographic AIs, and maybe they just did AIs. Not sure how the AIs worked, but apparently they didn't use them.
Maybe it was like an AI to control their ships, to like have a neurological link, so they can control their ship without even having to be at their controls.
That'd be cool. Yeah, I think we do the same thing with our ships. I think we kind of have a bit of an AI, so when we call our ships, they fly down and they don't blow us up. Yeah, it's kind of interesting. I've got one artifact, I just gotta find another one. Oh, someone talked. What would be interesting is finding out what these guys actually look like. Because all the data says is just text data, so they won't give any pictures about what they actually look like. We know the humanoids, so so the totems are not an indication about what they look like, but could be an indication of possibly an enemy. Yes. My last video, I was gonna add a picture to the video, but I forgot to do that, so I just added a link in the descriptions. So anybody is able to check out the totem that way.
Are there any inscriptions on the totems?
No. It seems like all the artifacts are built using a prism shape. So lots of triangles and they're all prisms, so lots of triangle shapes.
Yeah.
Seems to be very similar to the obelisks as well. Obelisks are all prism shaped as well. Still can't find these stupid artifacts. I got one relic, which is kind of like just a little growing thing that pops out of the ground, but I can't find any of the other freaking artifacts. They must have changed the spawn grounds for the site.
Might have to go the same structure but different spots.
Yeah. Probably all been picked up already by the other commanders here. I just can't find them. Could be unfortunate. Oh, I haven't got Sitch over here yet. Go Sitch over here, see if I can find them. Yeah, so probably won't be too much time before word gets out about this new site and get lots of commanders calling all over it.
That's probably right. A lot of people are going to hit private group and go into it that way.
Yeah.
Or even solo if they're on their own.
Yeah, definitely. Oh. And here's one of those beacons popping out of the ground. Yeah, it's pretty cool. When you get close to where the beacons are, they pop out of the ground. It looks like someone's already farmed this one, so.
So then there's like sensors on. So if it knows when you're coming towards it, maybe that's a sign of the AI. It's in their structures.
Yes, quite possibly. I wonder when we're going to find out what they look like, because in order for to find out, they must still be around. I say they're still around. It's just...
I think they'll stay around as well.
Yeah.
I mean, there's... If you just look at the galaxy on itself, there's... Like, we haven't even explored... Like, what we've explored is nothing compared to the size of the actual galaxy.
Yeah. But considering how close the other bubble we were right now to them, if they're space-worthy, so there might not be, maybe a pocket of them survived the war, but they just can't use, but they just lost the technology, so they just probably haven't reinvented space travel yet. Well, they could be completely wiped out, we don't know for sure, but that's what my speculation is, and I hope it comes true.
Well, seeing as they're ruins, they've obviously been there before. So maybe because it's like several ruins, they've expanded. But then, as a result of the war, they've had to retreat. Now maybe these ruins, they know where they are, and maybe they're kind of like waypoints for them to come back to keep an eye on those, on us. Because if that AI is like that beacon that's coming out of the ground, if it's doing that by itself, but it only happens when you approach it, then it's obviously receiving information that you're being there. So
yeah.
Maybe it's sending it somewhere. Maybe it's not. But being an AI, there's a possibility it could. And even if it doesn't send, it could be stored locally. Maybe underground, or something we don't know, because we can't check underground.
Yeah.
We can't exactly scan the whole structure. So maybe if they do come back, they'll go to those waypoints, get that information, and decide are we good, are we bad, then decide if they want to go to war with us.
Yeah, that's true. So far, all indications, as far as Ramtar is concerned, they're extinct. Maybe he's got some other data that says that says these things, and we just haven't been able to unlock it yet.
Yeah.
Of course, he could be wrong. I mean,
it's all speculation, so.
Yeah, it's all speculations until we find the home world and go there and check it out, see if they're still there.
We
say, hey, we found your wounds. Sorry, but we left the place in a kind of a mess. So these are the ruins. I'm going to keep on trying to find another artifact so I can start scanning something. So in the meantime... what's going on? My game just crashed. Yeah, connection error, and we're back. Sorry about that technical difficulty, but as you just saw, I got disconnected. So the disconnection bug for the ruins is still around. Where the heck am I? Oh, there I am.
Is it Luke, or is it just them kicking you out? They don't want you to find out their information.
Possibly stretching forth past the barriers of space and time to keep the most darkest secrets from you. So anyways, I can't remember what I was going to say before. Still trying to find the freaking artifacts. I can't find anything. I'm lucky to get this relic, that's for sure.
Yeah, these like relics, it's like you don't really know where they're gonna spawn. Seeing as it's a new site, it's like, are they gonna be there?
Yeah, so far I found places where they're spawning at, but there's nothing there, so. So they've probably been cleaned out already. So, anyways, what was going on? Okay, so anyways, yes, announcement for 2.3 has been announced. I mentioned that in my last vid, and this is going to be multi-crew and customized avatars. That's the official features that we know about. We don't know of anything else that'll be coming. We could be getting a new ship, finally. Possibly the dolphin will be introduced. That would be cool. We know it's supposed to be in the game by the time the launch of PS4 comes out, because it was in the PS4 trailer. So hopefully we get the dolphin. That'd be kind of cool.
The dolphin lineup. It looks cool. Just like the concept of it.
Yeah, it looks kind of cool. I mean, the back end kind of looks like the rear end of a, like the flipper, the tail of an actual dolphin or a whale or whichever. So that's kind of a neat little thing.
Yeah, it's like streamlined. It kind of looks like an orca, but a bit more streamlined.
Yeah, I haven't seen any concept art of the full thing. All I've seen is kind of like the back end. That's just from the trailer.
If you go onto elite-dangerous.wiki.com/wiki/dolphin and then look at the dolphin ship there, you can see like a front view, but it's like to the side of it. So you're looking at the side, but you can see the front and a bit of the back.
So is this a new concept art from the one they had before, or is this still the same one that they've had for the last year or so?
I'm not sure.
Okay. I'll take a look at it later and find out. Or everybody else can too. Anyways. So with 2.3 coming out, we know that the I think we're gonna get disconnected again. No, I'm just glitching.
Have you seen the Panther Clipper?
The what?
The Panther Clipper.
I've seen concept art of it, and it looks pretty cool. They say it's supposed to fit in the letterbox, but in previous Elite games, it was always considered to be too big to even fit in the letterbox, and had to do something else. So that's probably why it hasn't been released yet. I think they're actually going to be the first of these new, bigger ships that can't dock with stations.
Yeah. David Braben himself said the Panther Clipper, it is a big training ship, a bit like the Lacon Type 9's big brother.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, it's a big ship. It's a big ship and it's supposed to be well armored and well armed too. So, it'd be like a... But probably as slow as heck though.
Probably.
Or slow, can't be maneuverable, but it'd be hard to take on in combat anyways, because probably put turrets everywhere and have huge shields and huge armor.
You know, like, the speculation is the ass mark too. It's speculated there.
A new ass? A new type of ass?
A new type of ass. Ass mark too.
Oh.
It's speculated there.
Oh, cool.
It's referenced from Asp Explorer in-game description. There's also the crate, which kind of looks like a Viper, sort of. It's a small, reliable one-man fighter.
Oh yeah, there's a couple of fighters. I'm wondering if they're going to release fighter versions of the side one and the Eagle, or if they're gonna not have that as far as launchable ships are concerned.
I kind of like the concept of the Hunter, but there's no reference to it in the game, so I think this probably is actually gonna be fake.
I think the Imperial Fighter might be a version of the Hunter, because they kind of look similar.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah. So, well, I guess we'll find out what kind of new ships will be coming out. New fighter would be cool, would be pretty cool. A little bit more variety. That's the Condor and the Imperial Fighter. Definitely like the... Definitely like the Taipan. That's pretty cool how it folds up when it enters the hangar.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool.
The one thing they need to do though is in that Anaconda, you know, like the ship fighters, they need to be putting the Sidewinders in there as well.
Yeah, because in the description it says it can hold a Sidewinder. So
yeah.
Why can't it hold a Sidewinder?
Why that's can't not empty.
It's like I just gotta look for, oh yeah, so we can launch a surprise winder, awesome.
Yeah.
But I think probably the actual CQC one would probably be the actual launchable one would probably be a slightly downsized version of the Sidewinder, possibly.
Probably.
Yeah. Because you wouldn't need to hold any cargo or anything like that, so.
No, because the fighters, so there's no point. But there's, like cargo things might get swapped out for like shield banks or chaff launchers. Not chaff, but like shield banks.
Okay. So either I got a Bluegy here with some new paint jobs, so I'm gonna go take a look at it. Yeah. Well, it'd be interesting what the Frontier release is and what will be coming down the road in 2.3. And it just disappeared.
Yeah,
oh, he must have went offline. Shoot. Oh. Looks like he got disconnected as well. Hopefully it doesn't mean appear on top of me.
Okay. So, what if, like, what would you think would happen if the Thargoids came back into the bubble? Like, cause so far, we don't even know if they are, but we've seen an alien thing try to interdict us and that. But what do you think the reaction would be if it happened in the bubble?
Well, as far as the political guys are concerned, it'd be the same thing as if a foreign, any kind of foreign land would bring a, you know, one of their military type aircraft into a new territory. It's like, okay, you know what? That's pretty much a declaration of war. Back off, or it will be war. Type thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. I think that would be the official reaction, but they might be thinking it, but they just might not be backing it up for obvious reasons. They don't want to get into a war with a race that can, you know, shut down every ship that they encounter. So
yeah, I think that's what they're doing, but it's because they're like scanning our ships because they're disabling it, and then they're just like trying. They're basically running away from us because they're not even trying to like attempt to contact us.
Yeah, I think what they're doing is they're retrieving the probes.
Yeah.
Yeah, because
or they could be planning a full-scale invasion by like trying to scan our ships and get the schematics, get our weak points, and
yeah,
find out like where our power plants are, our vulnerabilities, and stuff like that.
Well, that could be why they're picking up the probes as well, because they contain all the information. Mm-hmm. It's probably why they can shut us down so easily. But anyways, not to divert to a new subject, is what else could be coming?
What else?
Probably won't discuss everything that could be coming, because I need to, you know, stretch this out and stuff. But one aspect with the arrival of commanders and stuff is, like with the new patch, is the possibility where we'll be getting the ability to walk around our cockpits at the very least. Because from the trailer for the PS4, you have a scene of a guy standing in the cockpit of a Cobra.
Yeah, but that could be the multi-crew thing, like.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, because that's coming in 2.3.
Yeah. PS4 is going to launch on 2.3, isn't it? Or is it going to launch on 2.4?
It's going to launch in June, so it might be for 2.4.
Yeah.
But it will launch with all the same features that PC and Xbox have. So that feature, being able to, you know, standing and walking around in our cockpits, might be already in the game for when the PS4 launches, or it might be introduced into the game as a feature for the PlayStation launch.
Yeah.
So
the thing is, though, with multi-crew, like, I think we're gonna have our own hell, because I'm just standing on Python here in a station, and looking around it, I can see like these health packs kind of things.
Oh,
so
okay.
Maybe there's gonna be an aspect of like going outside of ship and maybe combating, like we'll actually walk around on like the space station, try and find like pirates, because maybe we could work for the actual police like of the station. And then we have to hunt down the smugglers. Which would be an interesting mechanic, because otherwise, well, they put those like health packs inside the ship.
Yeah, so definitely.
They might just be cosmetic, but
yes. Well, we know in the next season it's gonna be heavily focusing on the first person aspect of the game. David Braben has said that some of the features, you know, would be able to board other players' ships or be boarded by NPCs. Possibly we could even board NPC ships. So we could. So I'm just wondering, in theory, is if we can actually hijack, if we have like a multi-crew, like someone could go on to the other ship and take control of that ship and then take it. And then we take it to an anarchy place or someplace in an anarchy system where it has a shipyard and sell it there and then buy a new ship.
Yeah. But then you're going to have people that are going to go into like surprise finders and then just like board people, like people's like anacondas and that.
Yeah, it's gonna cause some kind of problems. I don't know how Frontier is gonna work their way around that, but it'd be interesting to find out. And if our ship gets stolen, would that pretty much count as being destroyed? And then we just, you know, go to reload log screen, because, you know, being destroyed, we just get jettisoned and wind up back at the station.
Yeah. But there's gonna have to be like some sort of insurance, so, or at least a way to defend yourself that's gonna make it hard for both the boarder and the boardee.
Yeah, because one guy, one person, unless they're really good at first person shooters, are not gonna be able to defend a ship against three other player boarders, not unless they have something in place. So there has to be something that, you know, is given to players to be able to defend themselves should they get boarded.
Maybe we're gonna see the ECM have like a different use, because if thinking about it, the electronic countermeasures only disables the tracking so far, doesn't it?
Yeah, it just disables the tracking of the missiles.
Yeah, but it can do so much more if you think about what it actually is.
Yeah.
So maybe that could be a countermeasure of breaking their either their boarding lock or their ability to like remote access our ships. Maybe even just fire an EMP in general and just fry both ships as a final countermeasure.
It could be possible, but then if they're only on your ship, they're still running on your ship, and all they have to do is just after they take you out and throw you into airlock, they just have to reboot your ship and be gone again.
Yeah.
I guess the final countermeasure is self-destruct. Boom.
I guess kind of thing of like kicking someone out the airlock that's already been put in place, because you can go to these like USSs and then you'll see like drop pods there.
Yeah, escape pods. You can rescue people or NPCs that have been jettisoned somehow.
Yeah. So maybe we'll be, if we get attacked, we'll be one of those people that get jettisoned.
That'd be cool. Not too sure if I want to wait around and plan for someone to find me.
Yeah. We can always just call the fuel rats, but when the fuel rats in the world, they'll just be like the rescue people.
That would be cool, actually.
Well, who knows? But again, it's all speculation, so
yep.
It may or may not happen. You just have to wait to find out.
Yeah, for sure. Well, I can't find any artifacts, I can't do any scans to find out any new information, so I'm probably gonna have to do a show again dealing with any new information that we find out, anything new and interesting at some later point in time. Anyways, this is all the time we have for this episode. I'd like to thank you, Commander Kev Banufong. Banufong.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm very sorry about that.
No, that's okay.
So to all the views and stuff, Commander Kev Banufong is also hosts his own Twitch TV channel. I believe the channel is the same thing, Kev Banufong?
No, it is Banufong _JNR.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll provide a link in the descriptions for anybody who would like to check out his show. It's pretty good. I quite enjoy it. Send him a a quick follow and enjoy his show.
Alright, thanks. Thanks for having me on your show.
Yeah, no problem, man. We hope to do this again at some point later on in the future.
Alright, cool.
Sweet.
Well, I'll look forward to it.
Yeah, me too. It's always good to have people on.
Yeah.
Anyways, to all you viewers and commanders out there, take care and fly safe. This is Firebot 13 and guest Kev Banufong signing off. See ya.